Ladies and gentlemen, there is a new show coming on Stars that I might have to beg Larry to review with me. I don't know. We'll have to see. I'm not feeling this the way I was feeling all the other stuff we reviewed on Stars, like P-Valley and Hightown, but I'm going to give it a trailer run to see what the fellas think. So here we go. It's called Run the World on Stars.
Another round?
Yeah. Remember when we were 21 and we could get in at 5 in the morning and just shake it off?
No, I have very few lucid memories of my 20s.
I know who I am. I got this.
Apparently, I missed the window for everything because I spent my 20s cooking, cleaning, and fucking my college sweetheart instead of that guy.
You are a black girl in America. Head up, eyes on the prize, world domination. World domination.
Brandon, I'm gonna give it to you first. I'm gonna give it to you.
Hold on, man. I'm scared to talk. I don't know what to say. Hey, man, it looked like a decent show to me. You know what I'm saying?
I'm like Sean Green. He said he feels like that should be on BET.
Hey, man, I'm going to check it out. You know what I'm saying? I don't know why Larry looked like he's going to die over here. Hold on now. Let's talk about the good here. It started off, first of all, it's all nothing but black people. We got some women that are looking pretty good, you know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. For my particular taste, I may enjoy it a bit more than P-Valley. It said it's from the makers of Living Single. Yeah. Which is a show that I did appreciate coming up in the 90s. You know what I'm saying?
I did.
I think it's worth a try. You know? I mean, why not?
I'm not saying I'm not going to try it.
Yeah.
I'm
watching the trailer like, okay, this looks pretty good.
You can
come back and y'all finna fall out the chair. I can't wait to see what Larry got to say. But, hey, I'm going to give it a try, man. I'm going to go in with an open mind and, you know, and may enjoy it. And it may be the next best thing, you know. That's what I got to say.
Larry, the floor is yours, my brother.
What's the problem,
Larry? Don't you want to support your people when it's quality material?
I'll say this: with the exception of the eye candy, there is absolutely nothing about this that show from the trailer that I saw that appeals to my demographic.
Okay. Larry, what's your demographic? What is your demographic?
I mean, I'm a black male in America, and I didn't see anything in particular in that show that made me want to watch it. I mean, there's beautiful women in there. I mean, I will say this, and I probably will support it and watch it, because it does seem like it's an all black cast. It seemed like that they were actually putting black women and black men together, which I always support. I'm definitely down for that. Mm-hmm. And for that reason alone, I will watch the show and support it so that they continue to show that. But I honestly, just from an interest standpoint, I didn't even see anything that about that show that even if I was a black woman, that would make me want to watch it. All they showed these three women that were doing these slow motion hero walks at their triangle for, you know, their triangle, you know, pattern and formation. And that was it. They're fashionable. They're in their 30s or 40s, whatever they're supposed to be in. And they basically wasted their 20s away. Okay. I guess if that's supposed to be something, commiserating with other black women, talking about how you spent your 20s and probably 30s looking for a bigger, better deal. And now that you wake up in your 40s and all you have is your career. Sure. Maybe there's some people that can relate to that, you know, but
Wow.
I didn't see anything in particular that makes me interested in watching that. I mean, yeah, I mean, I'm going to support because that's, you know, I'm going to support Black people and positive Black imagery to some respect. But
did you watch Living Single back in the day?
Huh?
Did you watch Living Single back in the day?
I did.
Okay.
I did. And Living Single was cool. It was cool, no doubt.
I liked it.
Yeah.
And you know, had I followed Kyle's career, I would have been doing stocks 20 years ago.
You know, sometimes I see these shows like this, and I guess I should reserve judgment. I mean, and sometimes I wonder about some of these shows that we watched back in the day.
Uh-oh.
Don't get me wrong. I think that they were good shows. They were entertaining for the time.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess I have to see what the filmmakers that were doing those shows back then, how they perform in today's standard. I feel like back then we had so few shows and so little representation on TV that we watched whatever was out there. You know, mm-hmm. I remember watching Homeboys in Outer Space because, well, it was a Black show on TV. It was garbage, but I watched it, you know, and so sometimes I wonder, the shows that we watched back in the day, were they as good as we remember, or did we just have a fondness for them because that's the only thing that we have?
Good point, sir.
I can solve that issue for you right now. Hell, just go back and watch it and see if it still has longevity, lasting value today, because we just got finished watching something that came out in the 80s. And we said it's just as good as today as we remembered it 20-some years ago. You know what I'm talking about? Coming to America.
Yeah, there were some. I mean, definitely, there were some things like Coming to America that were great. I think, like, The Cosby Show was great. You know, The Real World was great. But some of the other shows, I just wonder, like, and I'm not sure that I can go back and watch them with pure objectivity because I watched them when I was younger. So there is a certain affection to, you know, to going back and seeing it and being nostalgic. So I'm not sure I can go back and watch it objectively and say that show was good even by today's standards. But one thing is if we get to see that the same filmmakers, the same creators from Living Single create a new show today, we'll get a chance to say, hey, yes, they were that good then because they are that good now, you know? Yeah.
I know it's a different type of show, but I know what you're talking about because my brother said that Family Matters does not hold up at all anymore. He said he tried to go back and watch it and it's cringeworthy.
It is. Yeah. I 100% agree with that. I mean, except with the exception of like maybe one or two episodes, and I'm going to tell you guys something else that I loved back then, but if I go back and watch it now, some of y'all might throw arrows at me. I love the comedian, but I'm gonna just put this out there. It's cheesy as fuck if you watch it now compared to back then. The Martin Lawrence Show, that shit was cheesy as, I mean, it was just over the top slapstick comedy that was funny then, but when you watch it now, it's not funny like that. So I do believe that you can watch some shows back then with some objectivity, even though you've grown as thespians and as a human being, as a person, because back when I was young, I loved Martin. I would skip A Different World some nights to watch Martin. And now I go back and watch both of those shows. I was like, what the hell was I doing? Because A Different World still holds great value nowadays, even when back then it was great.
Right.
What was I doing skipping A Different World to watch Martin?
Bro, that's the first time I've ever heard that. I was watching, I don't know. I haven't went back and just watched episodes in full, but every time I see a clip, you know, I'm still laughing, you know?